Today on Cooking Up Love, we're going to make this super easy and delicious 7-layer taco dip. Makes you want to grab a chip and dig in, right? If you're new here, we believe sharing homemade food spreads joy and touches lives, and we show you how to make delicious food you'll be proud to share with friends and family, like this festive taco dip that's layers of flavor. And this is a great party dip. Everyone loves it. Let me show you how to make it. To assemble, I'm using a springform pan to build the layers, and then I'll transfer the dip to a serving platter. You can really use any dish. A glass bowl really shows off this layered taco dip too. First, I'm taking one can of refried beans. One of the secrets to this recipe is adding a half a can of green chilies to spice it up a bit, and it really makes it easier to spread evenly as the first layer. As always, I've put the recipe in the description box below. Mix 1 cup of sour cream and 1 package of softened cream cheese together. Add 1 tablespoon of your favorite taco seasoning. I'm using a homemade version, and I'll link to that recipe for you. Once the cream cheese mixture is spread to the sides, I like to add about 1 tablespoon of seasoning on top to give it a little more taco flavor. It makes it taste really good. If you love to entertain, check out our playlist for potluck favorites and appetizer recipes. And just a quick thank you for the likes and the comments. When you watch and comment on our videos, it helps other people find them, and we really appreciate your help. Next, add 2 cans of tomatoes. I'm using the medium spicy Rotel with chilies. And make sure that you drain the juices. I like to squeeze all of the extra juice out so the dip holds together and it doesn't get runny, which really helps if you have leftovers. If you use salsa for this step, look for a thick and chunky salsa. Now for the guacamole. Yes, you can buy it at the store, and it's also so easy to quickly make. I've got 2 avocados in a bowl, diced. I'm adding about 1/4 onion, diced, and 1 teaspoon of salt, squeezing in some fresh lime juice, and then mash it all together. The other layers have a lot of flavors, so I'm making a simple guacamole for this. If you want a really thick layer of guacamole, double this recipe. I'm going to push the avocado out to the sides so that the layer shows up really well. Some people add lettuce as a layer. I leave the lettuce off because this dip is a little awkward to eat with lettuce falling off of your chips, but you can easily make this recipe your own by adding corn, lettuce, ground beef. Let me know your favorite add-ins in the comments. For our next layer, I'm adding a bunch of flavor with pickled jalapenos, cilantro, and green onions. Spread them around liberally. For more spice, pile on more of the pickled jalapenos. Because we've got the sour cream and cream cheese mixture, I'm not too concerned with this amount being overly spicy for anyone. It's just a nice hit of spice with every other bite. Then I'm topping it with plenty of shredded cheese. Today I'm shredding some sharp cheddar. Feel free to use your favorite shredded cheese like Monterey Jack, Pepper Jack. We have new videos every week. Subscribe and ring the bell so you know when we've posted a new one. This dip is pretty much ready to go. I'm going to let this set in the freezer for about 30 minutes before removing the ring for that amazing layered presentation. Okay, to remove the ring, I'm setting the springform pan on 2 cans that are taller than the form, and then releasing the spring and dropping the form down. Voila! I'll just transfer this to my serving platter and then add a few last touches. The layers turned out amazing. I like to make this dip so it's not too deep and so people get a taste of all of the flavors in one bite. Our final layer is the perfect topping for this fiesta dip. First, drizzle on your favorite taco sauce. I'm using the Herdez Taqueria Street Sauce in the Roja flavor. Then some chopped black olives, and to make it look extra pretty and to let people know there's some spice inside, pickled jalapenos and cilantro on top. This 7-layer taco dip is best served at room temperature, and you can set it out for your guests ahead of time. And it's vegetarian, perfect for large parties with different food preferences. 7-layer taco dip is one of my go-to party dip recipes because everyone loves to devour it. It's perfect for game day, Taco Tuesdays, potlucks, harvest festivals, any event with a hungry crowd. Remember to subscribe before you leave so you'll know when we've posted a new recipe. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.